Hello everybody, today's lesson is about Sigbars, very popular Android widget. It's like a slider. You can take a slider, move it to another position and release it. And you see the app on your screen. I can tell you, my app has one linear vertical layout. The main layout is linear vertical. Then I have three nested layouts. They are also linear but horizontal. Inside linear nested layouts, I have a text view and a sigbar. Then I have text view where I mix the color. So probably a good idea just to understand the app logic. Let's just watch how it's working and then we go into implementation. If you remember the lesson with the spinners, we could generate more than 1,000 colors, but here actually it's unlimited. The number of the colors is unlimited. You can get lots of different combinations of red, green and blue. So let's watch how it's working. So you can drag the slider or you can just tap on a new position in the sigbar to move it. And the color not changing when I'm moving the sigbar. It's changing only when I drop my sigbar. And Let's analyze the coding. Again, before you start, you should ask yourself what layouts I need, what widgets I need, what events I'm going to catch and process. So we are going to need linear layout today. We are going to need just two widgets, text view and sigbar, and we are going to handle event number 6. Event number 6 is actually 3 events. So it's a group of events. User just touched the sigbar, user moving the sigbar, and user dropped, released the sigbar. So you can handle 3 events from the sigbar. But again, it's up to you which events to handle, which events to ignore. Let's analyze the coding. We start from the design. Let's take a look at component tree. You see how linear layouts nested. You see what inside each linear layout. So component tree is very informative window. because it shows you also relationship between widgets, but it's not Java classes tree, it's your application screen, how widgets and layouts are nested together to make your concrete app screen. Attributes. Probably it's easier to analyze attributes in XML view. Let's increase . So my main layout is vertical. I have 15 pixels padding. Layout width match. So my main layout trying to be as big as the whole device screen, but height no. Device, sorry, main linear layout doesn't try to be as high as the device screen. It's wrap content. Orientation vertical. You see now nested layout. It's now horizontal. It has two widgets. Text view with the text red and sigbar. I used weight. So for text view, one unit. For the sigbar, 4 units. So I divided the width of the layout into 5 parts. So 1/5 taken by the text view and 4/5 are taken by the sigbar. Also, I made the width for both of them 0, because if you're using weight attribute, you have to put 0 to the width of your widget. Gravity, quite important attribute. Let me show you what happens if I uncheck central. So my sigbar going to go a little bit higher than the text. If I check, it's going back to the center. So layout gravity, important attribute, but it has lots of options. Lots of options. What else I did for my sigbar? Very important attribute, maximum value. So I synchronize my sigbar and my colors, because my colors may change from 0 to 55. By default, sigbar changing from 0 to 100. So I change this number so I don't have to calculate the color. I just take sigbar position and it's my color. Very important attribute for the sigbar, max. You see another layout for the green. And you see the third layout for the blue. And finally, text view at the bottom of my main vertical layout. Margin, it's a distance above my text view. Don't confuse padding and margin. If you have a little bit web design experience, you understand the difference between padding and margin. padding is a space outside of the widget. Sorry, inside. Padding inside. Margin is the space outside of the widget. So it's not the same. Margin attribute and padding attributes. Okay, Java. Let's increase so I declared four variables for four widgets. I declare three integer for the colors. Instantiation, I instantiate four variables, lines 24 to 27. I register event handlers. Remember, this listener is three events. So when you type this, when you see red bulb, when you click on the red bulb, and when the Android Studio generates for you three event handler templates, you can see them. You see what Android Studio generated. Progress changed, user dropped, sorry, no, this one user just touched, this one user dropped. So I'm ignoring the first two events. I don't do anything, but I cannot remove them, because if I remove those two empty methods, my Android Studio is going to show me error message. So even you don't process them, you have to have them. So this listener is three different events. Accordingly, you have three different event handlers. Now what happens if my user dropped the sig bar? I get positions from three sig bars, and I mix new color. Very simple. That's how it's working. You've seen it. You've seen it. I drop sig bar, the color changes. If I'm moving sig bar, the color doesn't change. But let's make a very simple experiment. So what I'm going to do is I just cut and paste . So I'm going to now react on progress changed event. Let's review. Let's see what happens. So you see the difference. Now my color immediately updated. And it's up to you which approach to choose. If you choose the first approach, the user doesn't see the changes right away, but your app not working as hard. You don't process a lot of messages. Second approach, yes, you see the changes right away. This is good. But bad news is your app now has to catch lots of events and it may work a little bit slower. Because your graphic may be complicated. It doesn't have to be as simple as it is now. So we reviewed today SIG bars. One more time, look at the coding. Variables. Instantiation and registration. And application logic. So you understand now SIG bars and three events they can generate. Next lesson is very important. We are going to discuss input, how to type numbers or text in your mobile app and how to process events from the edit text fields. Thank you so much. Take care. Bye-bye.